you'll be feeling all that emotion that's going to attack you, and you have to deal with it, because they're telepathic. And like I said, every time you think about a spirit, and happy or sad, they know it and they feel it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I said, be prepared. I was like, prepare yourself, young brother. You know, prepare yourself. He's like, man, don't really matter to me, because nothing can prepare. And I don't think that grief can even compare to the grief I was feeling in my life. I don't know, he didn't elaborate on his grief, but he was really hurting inside somehow. There was something going on. I think he was really sad. Depressed, probably. And like a lot of say, this like life wasn't treating him fair. I think that's what he was feeling.
Living day by day.
Day by day, and he felt like life had nothing to offer him anymore. So he was like, man, I'm at that point where I don't give a fuck what happens.
And when he crossed over, he was pretty much happy to be there.
He was very happy to be there. I've seen several others like this. And it doesn't always happen like this. The next thing we're going to mention is a case of it not being like that. But, you know, this guy with, like, hours, he just died, like, an hour and a half before. We died at, 3:30? And then 2 hours later, 5:30, he's sitting in my living room. We're having a conversation on the south side. You know?
Yeah.
Because they drudge on the people who can hear him, and this is what we do. We're not trying to make light of anything that happened with your friend or family. We're telling you the truth.
Yeah.
You know, the truth is sometimes stranger than even science fiction for some people. This stuff is very different than what you're gonna feel.
Yeah.
But call him, he'll come to you, you know. Learn to be happy for him, for Jay. You know, because if you can cry, part of the tears and stuff, maybe that's part of it, the experience, but you need to find some way to be happy. If you could just feel what he's feeling, like for a second, you would never cry again when someone died. He felt that kind of joy, you'd be laughing at his funeral and giving applause for him and joy and like giving toast for him and toasting for his happiness.
A lot of people may not understand that, but at the same time, like the body the form that body goes into after the physical body dies, you know, it also feels the grief and everything from everybody else. So while we say try to be happy for him and party and stuff for him, and so, you know, both sides don't deal with so much grief, you know.
Yeah, that's right.
Do something a little bit different.
Something the Lord Buddha taught us, actually, it's in one of our videos it's not on the YouTube page, but it's on Facebook, one of those videos that happens to be on there. Like, I remember Lord Buddha coming through during a reading for somebody that we're videotaping and saying with comments about that when people are grieving in this physical dimension, the spirits are feeling all that grief. And inside, they're like, oh, my God, they're dying inside. They're dying inside themselves because I died. You know, what do I do? And, you know, it's tripping up the spirits.
Yeah, it does. I think
that was Lord Buddha's comment.
Yeah, you have to definitely take what Lord Buddha says in the consideration. Yeah.
Take that to heart, because it's the truth.
Also want to touch on the situation of Pee-wee.
Now, we're going to this is the vice versa of Jay. You know, this person has been dead since last November. He crossed him last November. But yet, Pee-wee, this is a person that was referred to us, and we're gonna explain a little bit about it here. We're gonna talk to the family some. Still, we still need to talk to some of them, but we're gonna explain to you all because it's been a very valuable tool for everyone to learn about the truth of death. And look, this dude Pee-wee was murdered. Another young dude. You know, I think he's from Richmond, possibly. I mean, maybe Petersburg. Petersburg or Richmond?
I thought it was Richmond.
Richmond. All right, that's kind of how I'm feeling too. Yeah. Anyway, when he crossed over, when he was shot, you know, instead of going through the portal to the light, he started tripping. You know,
he's in a self-imposed hell.
And put himself in the self-imposed exile dimension, which is what I call it, or self-created hell. because he hated himself. He hated his life. He hated who he was. He hated the way he lived his life. He thought God was angry. He thought he was going to hell. Yeah. You know, he didn't give a fuck anymore. He didn't know anyone to even, try to pretend like he didn't exist anymore.
Yeah, he was a real hard.
We had to track it down. Usually we can track down any spirit. Any spirit will come to us. We can force them to come if we want. We knew we had to force them, but we had to force them. It took us. We had to combine our power. To bring them in.
When Pee Wee was coming in, it seemed like he was behind like a dark cloud with little red around him, but peeking his head in and out.
Like he was ashamed of something.
And then I heard him asking for our assistance, you know. So, well, we went on and did what we had to do.
We did what we had to do, you know. We weren't sure what to do. It started on Saturday, trying to figure out what the deal was. Explain a little bit. Let me write something down here.
Yeah, I mean, we had been wondering what was going on with him, and just kept getting a little bit of this, you know, in and out. So we go send him some energy, you know.
That's right.
Try to send him more energy. And like today, it was the same thing. We sent him energy, but then we...
But then we went further.
Yeah, we went.
I jumped in the portal.
Yeah.
This time, I sent the energy of all... Jeremy sat out, you know, and observed, did remotely view. I jumped in. I sent an extension of my spirit in there to his dimension, you know, to stand there with him and feed him energy. Basically, I'm gonna spoon feed it into him.
And I started seeing. You know, I started seeing that Matt was doing that. I could see him in glimpses of his whole body for the first time, you know, that I didn't see before. In and out, in and out, in and out.
I was just going like this, like had light coming out of my hands and stuff, clearing them.
He was like falling apart, talking about help, help, help me, and he was getting help, you know, at that time.
At that time, Lord Buddha appeared.
Yeah.
You know, Lord Buddha and his monk, Entourage appeared.
And we said to go with Buddha, that he was Lord of Compassion, that he wouldn't leave, you know, we wouldn't leave
Buddha. We weren't even leaving straight, neither with Lord Buddha.
Not at all.
And we heard Lord Buddha saying to him, like, you know, you must come, child. You know, that's what he's saying, child, you know, if you receive help, you must come. You know, and he's like, I am the Buddha.
Yeah.
You must come. I am the Buddha.
When he says that, he's serious.
You know, repeated over and over, I am the Buddha.
Yeah.
And we were talking to him also on the side. We were like, look, the Buddha is the Lord. The Buddha is the Lord of the compassion.
Yeah.
It is the Lord of the compassion, not a Lord, the Lord, the Lord. You know, and you can trust him. And I was like, don't be scared. He's like, I'm scared. I heard him saying, I'm scared. What if this, what if that? And the Buddha was like, you must go through my child. Do not be scared, child. He's like, child, do not be scared. Do not fear. Something like that, Lord Buddha said.
Yeah.
And then I turned to him and said, you know, it's all right. You're going to be fine. You're going to be healed in a second.
That's right.
And the portal was already sitting there waiting for him, blowing open that doorway. I walked through, Jeremy walked through, he walked through, Lord Buddha, the monks walked through, went through the whole entourage.
Even Christ came
through. Yeah. You know, we were all there. You know, and we took him over, and he had this big smile on his face once he went through. He was like, oh my God, you know, he was like, where am I? You know, what is this? You know, I could still feel what you're saying, that.
Tears of joy.
Tears of joy in his eyes. And I was given the directions. I'm like, stand, go into the circle here. What they usually see is a circle for the healers. Go around to heal damaged and broken spirits like him. I was like, go ahead, stand still and let them circle around you, Pee-wee. And then me and Jeremy joined in the circle along with the monks. You know, and put our hands just like this. This is how we do it. It's like this, all of us. And Pee-wee right there in the middle in the circle. And indigo light just coming, go flying out of all our fans. Clear indigo light is shining into them, you know. Radiating all this stuff, this good energy, and ripping out all this negativity, you know.
Yeah, I was shooting like white light and